What's up, Divine Feminine? I did not hear you there. Didn't see you there. Divine Feminine, you know when you come in here, you're supposed to make yourself notice. Get in them comments. Say hi to me. Hi, Divine Feminine. Okay? I got a little music playing in the background just to give you a little chill mode. I know my head is looking crazy. I didn't comb my hair last night. I forgot to tie my shit up, so it's all nappy and frizzy looking, y'all. So we're here for the message. We ain't here for what I look like, all right? But I just want to pull a little energy to see what's coming towards you, Divine Feminine. And regardless of what comes out in these cards, in this message, just know that you are protected, okay? Just know, if you don't know anything about protection, then you are still capable of healing yourself. And if you came to my channel trying to find out what's going on between you and your person, or what's going on with your person and somebody else, I'm here to tell you the truth, because the truth tells me, okay? So please keep in mind that this reading may or may not resonate with your energy. Only take the parts that resonate with you and leave the rest. If it don't fit, don't force it. Just relax and let the shit go. Now, Divine Feminine, I can say this is a karmic reading. I can say it's a divine masculine reading. Divine reading, but it's what that comes out, what comes out in the cards. If I say he, it could be a she. It could be a family member. It could be a group of friends. It could be a coworker. Coworkers. Okay. But the first card that came out is somebody in your energy. Divine Feminine wants a casual ass relationship with you. Now, Divine Feminine, you may want the same thing. You have a King of Cups that's moving slow. They're moving slowly towards you. Because they are getting out of a relationship. They're going through a breakup. So this is why they want casual sex with you. No strings attached. Because they're going through a breakup. Okay. Tell me more. Why does this person want no love but just sex? King of Swords in reverse. Player. The Fool. Six of Swords. Somebody unfaithful. It could be something going on at your job. But the heart of your energy, Divine Feminine, is you dealing with a player. This person, you must praise them. But they're low vibrational. They do drugs. They drink. They're toxic. Now this is not for everybody. Okay? It's for somebody. It may or may not resonate with you. And this could be the energy of you. This could be the energy of somebody close to you. This could be the energy of an ex who you detached from. This could be the energy of someone coming towards you, okay? But somebody is wanting somebody to be in some no strings attached type of relationship because they're a player. Now, this person can be a water sign, Cancer, Pisces, or Scorpio. Or this person can be Aquarius, Libra, or Gemini. Okay, so it's like Divine Feminine. You have two, my ear is stopped up. You have two kings in your energy. One, both of them players. Both of them. But the difference between them, you look at this King of Cups as an excellent life partner. He's compassionate. He rushes in with love. He's a fine friend. Wouldn't it be nice to meet somebody like that? That's not a player. And this other, this air sign, this King of Swords, he's in reverse. This could mean this person, he's not thinking before he's acting when it's, he's just standoffish. He is no fairness when it comes to this person. It's like he comes in quick, goes. In Divine Feminine, I also see the energy of a young male. Three. You got three? You got two kings. And you have a youngster. It could be younger than you. And you have two kings that can be older than you. Okay? These two fellas could possibly be the same age. And the whole thing, Divine Feminine, I hate to say it. Now, this ain't for everybody. If you're Divine Feminine, if you're feminine out there, and you got three men in your life. One for the Father, one for the Son, and one for the Holy Ghost. I don't know why I said that. But they play us. All of them. That's the heart of your energy. You're dealing with the player, the joker, drugs, toxicity. Now, see, the thing is, all three of these men in your life. Now, they don't have to be somebody you, all of them don't have to be. It could be just three masculines in your life. And you're having a casual sexual relationship with one. Two of these other two could be your brother or something. You know, family member. I don't know. Or they could all be somebody you're talking to. They're all players, regardless if they're your man, if they're your homeboy, if they're your brothers, they're players, okay? And they're around a lot of low vibrational energies. But see, Divine Feminine, you're independent and you think for yourself, you act on your own, and you stop listening to others. And if you're not married, it will lead you to a successful marriage or relationship, okay? So just set your heart on victory. Don't stop because you got these players in your life. And if it's like, if you're in a relationship with this person, someone is not being completely sincere. Now, if it's you in the Six of Swords energy, Divine Feminine, you can be, like, you can say, you tell your man, your relationship, your partner, husband, you paid $50 for some shoes or a purse, but in reality, you paid $150. Okay, those are considered as minor infidelities too, is deception. Even though you don't feel like it, you know, that could be the minor things that you're doing. You're not actually laying down with nobody. You're not having sex with nobody. You could just be cheating by telling your husband, oh, I paid so-and-so for this, but it really cost this much. That's how Okay. Now, for some of you, it could be actually infidelity with these players. But I don't like this divine feminine. You good, but you dealing with some players. Three of them. One of them has deep passionate love for you, but they still a player. So I'm gonna get a little energy on this King of Swords. Okay. So Holy Spirit, clarify this King of Swords for Divine Feminine. Who is this King of Swords in reverse? The clarity of this King of Swords in reverse for Divine Feminine. Clarity for Divine Feminine. And this King of Swords. Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. Bring the energy on this Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, Masculine. Okay. Give me more energy on this King of Swords. Basically, whatever is going on. Whatever is going on with this King of Swords, Spirit is wanting you to enjoy today and stop worrying about tomorrow, Divine. They want you to be content and celebrate. Stop worrying about tomorrow and celebrate today. Because anything that has been causing you pain is being reversed. All you need to do is put it in the comments. The pain is reversed. I rebuke it in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I rebuke it in the name of Jesus or whoever you worship. Okay? Because an excellent day is coming and you're feeling good, even though maybe, you know, you feel good that you got three kings. Okay? Even though they play as Divine Feminine, it makes you feel good. You got the cups out here. I see joy and satisfaction. You're very pleased and relaxed. Putting your feet up. They spoiling you, Divine Feminine? You got good intentions. You release anxiety. So maybe you're feeling like, oh, well, shit. They play us. It's like you don't have no strings attached to them. You're like, even though you know they're a player, and they don't want no strings attached. It's like this casual thing, no strings attached, is leaving you free to okay. I hear it, Divine Feminine. You're weighing out your options. Mm-hmm. It could be you wanting a casual relationship. And you got three. You got two kings and a knight. They players. Or you could be the player, Feminine. You could be the player. Because I said, what is the energy of Divine Feminine? I'm going to stop saying so much Divine Feminine because it's more feminines in here than divine. There is some young coming, upcoming divine feminines in here. Okay? If you're a feminine and you've come to my channel and you don't know that you're divine, you'll soon learn and understand if you're a divine feminine or if you're a karmic feminine. Okay? But somebody is a player. Now, like I said, divine feminine, you could be the player and you got three cats coming towards you. Or you can be in a casual relationship with three cats. And you're not playing, they're the players. So take that where it resonates. Some of you could have been in a relationship with this person or these people, and you stopped doing your part. You stopped taking care of what needed to be taken care of when it came to a relationship. Okay. Okay, clarify this, King of Cups. An honest young man, sincere. This King of Cups has a younger brother. He's a little young. He's an honest little young man. He's marriage material. Or this could be you, Divine Feminine. When I say clarify this King of Cups, two younger male energies, masculine energies came out. Ooh. Oh, damn. Hell no. I'm just letting you know. These are some 99 cent. Store cards that I'm doing this reading with. I wrote messages on what each card means, what each suit means. And I'm just gonna light a cigarette because I'm seeing some other energy now. Jamari, bring me my vitamin water. Yes. Ooh, we divide feminine. Thank you, baby.
You're welcome.
Okay, divine feminine. I'm gonna have to get, this may be a long reading, baby. This may be a long reading. It's a lot of men out here. Now, this could mean that your masculine has a karmic family, his homeboys or something. He hang around a lot of dudes. I heard a motorcycle gang or something. I don't know where that come from. It's like somebody is in a motorcycle gang. Don't you hate when a top falls and you can't find it? It didn't roll somewhere way over there. This is my favorite vitamin water, the pink one. Focus, focus, focus. Okay, Divine Feminine. Yeah, maybe some of y'all need to focus. But it's a lot of men out here. I see brothers. I see two brothers. They both could be water signs, Cancer, Pisces, or Scorpio. They're both honest, fine friends, excellent life partners. Friendship, marriage material. This is a king and a jack. Okay. Now, the way I look at it, as a king and a jack, they're in the same suit, so they're related. And with this king, I believe this is a younger brother. Okay, because you know the king of hearts, the jack of hearts, the queen of hearts. Okay, this is how I read. Okay. This is two brothers, Divine Feminine. Now, there's also another king out here. These are all men. King of Hearts, King of Cups, Knight of Cups, Knight of Wands, Knight of Pentacles. Eight of Wands. Don't that sound like some, sounds like I feel like a divine feminine is out there. It's not for everybody, but it's a particular divine feminine out there. Either it's a lot of men in your life, or the masculine you with has a lot of men in his life. Now, those men could be sex partners. Those men could be his family members, his gang, his homies, you know. One of them has money. He's liking his job. He's not a good employee. This person, he's younger. He could be younger than you, divine feminine, or young-minded, adolescence type energy. He got money, but he always takes more than he's allowed. He's intelligent, but he's untrustworthy. And there's another man in your life that is sincere, a sincere lover. Him, this is a fire sign. Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. This Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius is in competition with this Earth sign, Capricorn, Taurus, or Virgo. They're in competition when it comes to money over you, Divine Feminine. Now, I don't know who that's for. Then you got these two brothers. An older one and a younger one. I know they older. They're not twins. And you have this king of swords that comes quick. And comes quick. I'm gonna leave that there. But it's a joker. Now this could be some same sex shit that you're unaware of that's going on around you. So I'm gonna get another deck. Cause did no queens come out? Did no female energy come out? You didn't even come out, Divine Feminine. And it being the overall energy of a casual relationship, casual sex, no strings attached, is because this person is either they male friends are giving them bad advice to stay away from you, to have a no love, telling them, no, man, don't, you know, no love. It's just time for sex. No love. Now, all those men could be, you know, talking that trash to me. So, that means you're dealing with a karmic-ass family. So, I'm getting my clown cards. This is going to tell me the energy surrounding this casual relationship, why this person is having a casual relationship. Or this could be you, Divine Feminine, wanting the casual feminine, the casual relationship, because you got all these options. Okay? So take it where it resonates. Okay. Divine Feminine. I mean, feminine energies. Y'all know I smoke. So, I gotta hit my blunt to recharge. it ain't a blunt no more. It's just a little roach, but I gotta hit it to recharge my crown chakra. It's yours too, my feminine. Did you know marijuana, cannabis, stimulates your crown chakra in your third eye? I used to smoke it for recreational purposes. Now I smoke it right before I do a reading so I can give you the most clear, accurate reading that I can give and to give you a good message of healing. So this reading ain't over, because after I pull from this card, I know if you're dealing with somebody that had you in a casual relationship, you're going to need some sort of healing advice. So we go in there next. So just give me. Y'all know I can get goofy, okay? Actually, I'm the goofy one in my family. Real shit. I am. Okay, so, did you hit your trees? Did you sip your wine? Feminine, did you? Okay, so, what is the energy surrounding this karmic family that this masculine, that divine feminine is thinking about, is dealing with? Tell me about this karmic family. You like that music, divine feminine? I thought we'd just have a little chill session. Okay, so Holy Spirit, many angels, ancestors of the highest, whitest light, show me the energy surrounding this casual relationship concerning divine feminine. Show me the energy surrounding this casual relationship. A water sign, Cancer, Pisces, or a Scorpio? Didn't I say that earlier? In the heat of the moment, I fell into temptation. But I can be your king if you let me. But you need to protect your foundation because I'm stalking you. But don't get used to my toxic energy. Because I got a spiritual group that's attacking. Damn, told you. But hey, I'm learning how to balance my emotions. I know. I'm trying to get you back, feminine. Can we try again? But feminine, you said, not my monkey, not my circus. See, now they want to marry you. Did you stop chasing them? See, if they had you in a casual relationship and you don't want that and you stop chasing them, now they're going to want to marry you. Okay, tell me more about this water sign. See that at the top? The water sign is the one who got a spiritual group attacking. This person is a Dunchi. Get your energy back from them, okay? And if you don't know what a Dunchi is, a Dunchi is the clown music that I usually have playing on my page. And you go Dunchi, Dunchi, Dunchi. A person who walks to the sound of clown music. That's a Dunchi. I made that up. Me and my siblings said this a long time ago. that you need to release this person because they're trying to take you to the circus. Mm-hmm. This person, for some of you, they always hungry. Somebody have to hide their food when somebody comes around. They smell food first, always begging, can I have some? Picnic baskets. Again, and you threw their ass in the tent. Look. He came and asked you for something and you threw their ass in the tent. See? You threw them in the tent. This came first. So it's like this little bear, this little yogi bear coming towards you. And you like, well, just roll your ass right on up to that tent. Just gone. Look at him. Look at him. The first to smell food, this is a greedy motherfucker. Okay? This is somebody who's always in your refrigerator begging. You could be sitting in your car and they'll smell your food. This is somebody, either your person's homeboy, his family member, or somebody in his family is a greedy motherfucker. This water sign. And this water sign, in the heat of the moment, they fell into temptation. This is why they want casual sex with you. This is why Spirit is saying don't get used to their toxic energy, because they want you to continue to be in this toxic ass relationship. Multiple partners. I told you. So watch others' energies around you. Don't let them fool you, okay? When you leave, don't forget to pick up your feelings. They envy your success, sweetie. And they're filling up your basket now. Money, perfume, gifts. Have fun in the sun. Happiness, joy, stability. Someone is having a tower moment. There's a pregnancy out here. Balance it out. Divorce on the rise. So my sweetie divine feminines, my feminines, the sweeties. This person has multiple partners. You may have found this out and you told this person, you know, they could have came back to you like, they sorry and this and that. My family told me this, or they people told them this, told them that. But it's like you're enjoying your success. You're enjoying your stability. You're enjoying your abundance. And this is giving this person a tower moment, okay? Because basically, they chose their family over you, which could be, again, their immediate family, their homies, their best friends, you know, their school chums or something. And now that you've turned your back on them, they're having a tower moment and they're trying to come and bring you gifts, okay? And when don't get used to their toxic energy right up under this card, you see that? They're going to come and try to be offering you gifts and stuff. Okay. This is a monkey trying to bring you back to the circus. You don't want to go. Okay. Divine family, don't forget to hit that thumbs up button for me. Energetically donate to my channel, and if you're feeling the need to, you're feeling loving, caring, and generous, if you'd like to send a donation to me, the information to my PayPal and my Cash App is in the description box below. Okay, so tell me more, Spirit, about this person trying to what is the tower moment? What is the tower moment? Ooh. Jail. Prison. Now, the tower moment could be you put them in mental prison. You got them in emotional prison. You're balanced out. And now they're in jail with their multiple partners. Oh, that's confirmation. all of the men, multiple partners, jail, prison. Ooh. Some of you, this person, these are friends from jail, or they could be friends in jail, if you know what I mean. Okay, give me more, spirit. Dark energy, evil eye protection, witchcraft, kitchen witch. My ex done black magic on me. Now I'm, wow, okay. Now I'm clearing my energy. Sandbox bully. So he's telling me who has a, somebody's ex is doing dark, sending dark energy to him, witchcraft. This is a kitchen witch. This is someone, okay, so since we got a kitchen witch out here, I got a kitchen witch oracle deck. I'm gonna have to bring it in here. But yeah. This person, see, their ex done black magic on them. Now, where's jail time coming? Dark energy and my ex done black magic on me. This ex is a sandbox bully. This is somebody who this masculine been with, been knowing since they was little. The girl probably bullied him. This is a Restitution, if that's her name. Restitution. I don't know, the Eddie Murphy character. This is her. Somebody is this, that relationship is if they was married, it's a divorce on the rise. Now, you could be divorcing this person and they having a tower moment. And they're trying to tell you that their ex did black magic on them. And now they're cleansing their energy from their space. But it's too late now, Divine Feminine, because you're divorcing them. You done put them in jail. If it's not literal jail, you done put them in mental jail. Spiritual prison. It can be all three. You can really be in prison. And spiritual prison is like, my nose itching. Spiritual prison is like going through poverty, all sorts of negative things because you did somebody dirty. Now I'm in this motel and I'm like, I'm not gonna say I'm reaping. They're trying to send the energy of me being homeless. I'm not homeless. I'm just without a roof over my head. I've got my storage is full. They tried to make me lose everything. They thought I was gonna lose everything, but I didn't. I kept my shit. I caught it. I caught myself, okay? My brother and the lawyers and attorneys and shit did me wrong. Now I'm up in this hotel bathroom because I exposed their ass. So they evicted me. But victory is going to be mine and victory is going to be yours because we came out of that chaos and conflict, right, Divine Family? Mm-hmm. It's time to upgrade and evolve. It's some nosy ass motherfuckers. It's somebody out there, Divine Feminine, a particular person that's watching you upgrade and evolve. Now, this person is coming back talking about they want to spend time with you. They want to take you out. But Spirit is saying, enter at your own risk. They're trying to take you to the circus. Okay? Enter at your own risk. It's very low vibrational energies. Spirit is saying, when you're around this person, to put salt around your doors and your windows, they come into your house. Because this person is going to try to have you locked up in some sort of entrapment. While you're feeling free and unbothered, they want to trap you. Mm-hmm. So don't get back into that. toxic. It's a toxic parasite inside of that tent. And they're trying to pull you in there. Perfect example. When you put salt around your doors and windows. You know, when you don't like snails and slugs coming around, and you put salt around your shit, around not your shit, but around your plants to kill the snails and stuff. Spirit just showed me. That's, you know how a snail shrivels up when you pour salt on it, or a slug? That's how spirits, bad spirits, they shrivel up, wither up like that. And they just, like when you sprinkle the salt on them, and you come back the next day, what do that snail look like? I like that thought. So this is what some of you just, you know, like I said, keep them spirits away from you. Because see, some of you divine feminines was dealing with a cheetah, a dog, an unfaithful human being. You gave this person one chance and one chance only. You training them and teaching. You showing them what you ain't gonna tolerate. Some of you, this person's mother, you may have a child with them. And their mom is a shit-starting granny. She's the ringmaster. If this is a literal family coming to you, the grandma is, she starts a lot of shit. Now, like I said in the beginning, this could be your immediate family. It could be your masculine's immediate family. It can be your masculine's homeboys. People at work that he talked to about you. Church, cult, sports team. All of that can be any family. Okay. Okay, so now I gotta get some healing advice for you. Y'all like that music? It's real chill, huh? Thumbs up even if you don't like the message and you like the music. Thumbs up if you don't like my mouth talking too damn much. Am I talking too much? Give me a thumbs up. Thank you. I love you too. Okay, Spirit, here we go again. Here we go again. Show me the energy surrounding divine feminine, the feminine energies in here, how they can heal from this casual relationship shit. How can they heal from this? No strings attached. Yeah, it's an emergency that you heal. You need to heal. That's crazy. When I'm doing my readings and I start speaking about the healing, the paramedics or the fire truck always come. And that's confirmation that some of you, it's an emergency that you heal. Because this no strings attached shit, that's not good for you. You want individual love. Okay? Okay, so Spirit, show me the energy coming towards Divine Feminine and the advice. Huh? Oh, hold on. Okay, I'm sorry about that, you guys. I'm in a hotel. That was the maids coming to give me some more towels and stuff. And if you guys would like to donate to me, I would really appreciate it, because I'm not getting any assistance. I'm not working right now. I had a stroke. I need help. I was evicted from my father's house, from my brother, and in some sort of illegal way, he got the administration over my father's house. So, and he's on drugs. And I'm in this hotel, and my relocation fee has moved out, ran out. So I'm asking everybody, instead of telling you a long sob story, I need the help to help me pay for this room, because I have a special need child. And he's an adult, but he has the mind frame of a 12-year-old. And they wanted me to put him in a shelter. They was gonna send us to a shelter. I'm not gonna be here forever. It's just, they're telling me until Christmas. So I'm asking everybody to send me donations. I went and I tried to stay in the very cheapest hotels out here where we live for $60, and I paid for 7 days there, and ended up staying there 2 days. Had to leave because my son, he's autistic, and that wasn't a good place for him. So where I'm at now is calm, it's cool. Sometimes we hear, loudness. Sometimes people get out of, people argue. They argue up in these hotels and shit. And I've been seeing women around here with men, and it's like, I be wanting to help them so bad. They it's like these women and ladies. I'm here in this hotel, and I see these women checking in the hotels with these men, right? And they are some abusive ass motherfuckers. Okay, I'm just being real. The women, this one lady, she had such a sad look on her face that she looked at like the screen, the screen. And I'm not trying to be funny. The sad, she just had a sad look on her face. And she was walking behind her man. He was walking and just leaving her, like he had just yelled at her and in the hotel with me. And they're coming out of their room, and I was coming back from the front gate, and she just looked sad. He spoke and smiled, and she didn't even look up. She was just walking with her head down. That broke my heart. I'm like, he's a narcissist. I sensed it. He all smiling and happy and shit, and she's upset. And the reason he was smiling is because she's upset. Laughing at your pain. Okay? Like to see you hurt. He's abusive. So, ladies, it's time to start taking your power back. Stop letting these men control you. Okay? It's time to take your power back. I don't know who that's for, but shit. Withdraw your energy from them. Block them. Stop calling them. Stop giving them open doors to keep coming back in your life with that bullshit. Again, I don't know who that's for, but stop that shit. You ain't doing nothing but hurting yourself. They holding you hostage and they fucking somebody else. Fuck that shit. They ask go. So Spirit, give me some advice, more advice for my divine feminine and my feminine energies out there. Surrounding me. Give me a good, clear message for this casual relationship bullshit that my divine feminine is dealing with. do it 3 times, even though it makes my hand hurt. One for the Father, one for the Son, and one for the Holy Spirit. Flow. Go with the flow. You cried enough. It's time to spread your wings. You hear me, Divine Feminine? It's time to change your focus to you. Coming together. If you have a child, focus on coming together with your child. Hold on. See, I got angry. The energy got too hot up in here. It got too hot. Amen. Yeah, some of you, some of you divine feminine energies, need to stop focusing on this casual sex and change your focus to coming together with your child. Show your child, your children. You have children, if you have a child. Some of you have 5 kids, some of you have 2 kids. Someone has a child that's 10 years old, someone has a child that's 5 years old, and someone has a child that's 2. Now, you could have all 3. Someone has a child that's 8 years old. I see some twins out here. I also see a child's heartbroken, okay? What else for the divine feminine? Feminine energies, what else? Strengthening bonds, okay. So what you need to do, sweeties, stop focusing, stop dealing with them casual-ass relationships. Don't deal with them. Mm-mm. With the strengthening bonds coming together, this has something to do with a child. And see, this green is representing love, your heart chakra. This red, strengthening bonds, is your root chakra, this grounding. Okay? Staying grounded, staying planted with your children. Some of you, these energies, these male energies come in your life. And some of them are energies to pull you away from your child, your family, to keep you from being nurturing towards your family. Okay? And I see some of you, you're just going with the flow. Okay? Tell me my spirit. Some of you need a green adventuring to balance your heart out concerning your child. You need a red jasper. Uh-huh. It just confirmed it again. A red jasper. This card is red. Someone is feeling alone. This may be some of you, you've strengthened your bond with your child. Some of you is like, man, fuck all this casual ass shit. I'm gonna hang with my babies. Mm-hmm. And now you're not feeling alone no more. Because you're strengthening bonds. You're coming together with your child, your children. You changed your focus. If you haven't, changed your focus to your children. Okay? Yes, Holy Spirit. And some of you need to get a purple amethyst okay? See, it says spread your wings. This is in reverse because you can't see. You're not thinking clearly. You're not using your crown chakra to see what's going on in these casual relationships. It's not helping you. It's not. Or this person that you're dealing with, them, you know, them having them. I'm gonna have to get some clarification on that too. On all of them men. Moving on. Okay, give me something spirit to cover. What's the card to go over this? Eight of Wands. Cover this eight of wands. No more sadness and isolation. Yeah, because when you let this casual shit go, you're not sad anymore because you're spending more time with your loved ones and your family. Coming together, strengthening bonds. Since you detached from that situation, you're no longer sad and isolated. Okay? You're going with the flow of what's going on in your family. Okay? Some of you opened your third eye. Okay, for somebody out there, they wasn't reaching out. They wasn't confronting the situation, and they didn't find balance. Now, this could be the energies, this casual relationship that you was in, these relationships, or if it was the casual relationship with you because your masculine has all these others, you stopped reaching out to them. You stopped trying to say something to him and it threw you off balance. Maybe you need to reach out. Some of you may have already reached out and confronted and nothing happened and you're off balance. Others of you, you have reached out. I mean, you need to say something. That's a shadow of something. Either reach out or leave them the fuck alone. Leave them where they at. Okay, so now these cards, Divine Feminine, Feminines, they are especially for the ladies. See the graphics in them? They're all women. So, let me get to these cards. But before I, that's going to be the energy of you. But before I go to the energy of you, we got to see what's going on with all of these men up in here. Is it some... lesbian, gay community stuff, and is this why your person had you in a casual relationship? You gotta give another card. So I got my other cards. I'm gonna find out what is the energy surrounding all these masculine energies. We gonna see. Divine feminine energy. Don't forget. Hit that thumbs up button for me to energetically donate to my channel. Okay. Okay, spirit, show me, why is this masculine, all these masculine energies, time, they spend a lot of time together. Okay, time showed up. Gambling. Something didn't end. Okay. So these are casual. They're going to stay casual. They're never going to end it. Okay, so Holy Spirit, show me the energy surrounding all these male figures around divine feminine. Why are all these male figures around divine feminine? A sneaky fox trying to get away with something. Something at a distance in another city or another state. You're gonna get some sort of information, a letter. This could mean that you're not, that you've been going back and forth with this person and now you're showing self-love to yourself. Some of you, it could be a stripper energy out here. Dancer. Okay. I see some feminines out here going, you've been going back and forth with the narcissist. Someone who don't want to end it with you, possibly because you live with them or they live with you. But you're not seeing this person as a great fortune. And the main the divine feminine. A lot of us women are dealing with sneaky ass foxes. Okay? Some of you have your sneaky fox is traveling either to another city or another state going to see other people. And this is why if you texting him, he ain't responding because he's trying to be sneaky. Now some of you, this sneaky fox could be trying to either send a letter to your house, trying to be sneaky, trying to get some mail from your house or something. Thank you, spirit. I've never experienced it, but it felt like something cold is in my pocket. Like a piece of ice, and I'm feeling like I wasn't looking up, but I am sitting on this toilet. I ain't doing nothing. I'm reading my cards, but I felt something cold, so I'm like, what is that? And I'm finna get some money, hopefully. Because usually with my right hand, I rub it in my pocket and I get some money. It don't matter if it's $2 or if it's $200, you know, I get some money. And I've never experienced where I rub my pocket, a cold spot, a cold chill, to feel kind of cold. But anyway, feminine energies, somebody don't want to end something. They probably live with you. Somebody that lives with you. Damn. Okay, so they live with you, but they want a casual relationship, like some friends with benefits shit. You ain't their main female. So when you try to call them or text them, they don't never respond back. But they don't want it to end with you. Because they want to be in the house with you. They live with you. This is a narcissist. And the reason I call this card a narcissist is because this is somebody that wants to spend time with you, right? But you see the dog, he could be coming, bringing you the leash, saying, come on, take me for a walk. Okay, but you see the collar on the ground right there, right? He could be, you know, saying, okay, I'm bringing you the leash. We gonna make people believe that where you going is where I wanna go. But we really, you taking me where I wanna take you. A narcissist, okay? Somebody who pretends to be something else. This a covert, okay? A covert narcissist. And he's in reverse, so that's a confirmation. Somebody is dealing with a covert narcissist, okay? That presents himself as a cute little puppy, but he's really a fucking pit bull, okay? He'll bite you. Okay, Spirit, show me the energy of all the male energies. There's a marriage came out. You may have a child with this person. I'm saying this person, but it's a bunch of masculine energies out here. So you have to take it where it resonates. Yeah, marriage in the ring, or this person proposed to you. To trap you. So I'm feeling like some of you divine feminines, somebody you're married to, and it is not for everybody. Somebody you're married to, they're around a lot of men, but they're using you because they're really bisexual. Okay? They got married to you, but they're attracted to men. And they use you to cover their tracks, like. Nah, he ain't gay. He married. That don't mean shit. And it don't mean shit if you got kids that you ain't gay or you're not bisexual. So don't let him fool you. Okay? Secrets came out. Secrets came out that you're not the main female. No, little baby. Secrets came out that somebody was sick and they didn't tell. Secrets came out that somebody was false. Secrets came out that somebody had a baby mama or somebody pregnant. Secrets came out. And this was why you're married to this person. So this person got sick. They got a baby on the way. They got somebody pregnant. And the person they got pregnant, they don't even know if that's their baby because they got somebody in the background. Okay? Tell me more about these secrets. Apology. This person is apologizing for being sneaky. And as I'm looking at the expression on the groom's face, he's looking like he didn't just came in here and knocked my cards over. Why are you trying to step across there? Hold on. Sorry about that, my little baby cat tried to walk across the tub and tried to step across my cards, and he slid in get out. after he slid and he hopped out of the tub real quick, I'm glad wasn't the water in there. Got out and sat there and looked at me like Urkel, like, did I do that? Yes, you did, little baby. That's what I call him, little baby. His name is Lightbulb, but I call him little baby. And when I call him Lightbulb, he don't answer. Because I've been calling him little baby since he was a little baby. He don't. Everybody else call him by his name, but he only comes to me if I say little baby. Okay, so tell me more about these secrets that's being exposed during this marriage or this proposal. There could be somebody coming to propose to some of you divine feminines that's sick and they're not telling you. Somebody is secretly trying to trap you. And they got some other shit going on, but they're trying to trap you. And somebody is sick and they're not telling you. And maybe they're trying to come back to you so they can blame you for a sickness that they got. Take that where it resonates. This person don't want you to move. They don't want you to change, or they refuse to change. And somebody is going to receive some sort of documents from the courts. Could be child support. It could be divorce. It could be real estate. housing something, child custody. DNA test or something. Somebody is thinking about you. They're thinking of how they can keep you from changing and continue to be cold and treat you cold because you're a privileged limit. Because you ain't having sex with them. Mm-hmm. And you ended a marriage with them. They're trying to figure out how they can, you know, continue to not put no toil and labor in a relationship with you, keep you broke, and continue to treat you colder than a polar bear's toenails. Motherfucker. Damn. And not have sex with you. So this person, they just want to trap you into some shit. They got a devil, okay? They don't want you to cut them off. They don't want you to end it. They want it to still be like a relationship. But they ain't doing shit. Fuck them. Let them go. Sign them divorce papers. Don't tell them. Sign them. Don't tell them. I don't know who that's for. But this motherfucker, all he gonna do is try to talk you to stay in the relationship. Because you got some sort of sudden wealth that he's after. Okay? He's being false. And he'll be getting your money. This may have already happened and got your money. He giving it to this bitch right here. And she giving it to him. He pimping both of them. It has something to do with it. It could have something to do with a house. Scandalous ass motherfuckers. They gon' don't worry about the divine feminine. They all gonna get karma for everything they doing to all of you. If you dealing with any of these motherfuckers that's in this casual ass relationship, trying to anchor you down, trying to keep you feeling like you should be at the bottom of the ocean somewhere. Or the fucking creepy crawlers is in the bottom of the ocean. That's the coldest place to be. Okay? Like this polar bear. He wants you to be cold, treating you cold. And then apologize to keep you coming back. That's their way of being sneaky, old bastards. Mm-hmm. And I'm gonna stop this reading because this I can go on and on. On and on. On and on and on. But no, I did say I gotta give my sweetie pies divine feminines. I gotta give you some personal women's advice. Okay. Let's see what's the energy of some of my divine beauty pies out there. Divine sweetie pies, beauty pies. Oh, that's the divine beauty pies. That's the new name for my divine feminines. You're my beauty pies. I'm going to have to write that down. Now. Now, y'all give me a thumbs up. This is basically an extended reading. And I'm asking you to donate to my channel. Because I'm eligible for the YouTube members thing. I'm eligible for it, but I don't want to do it because it you only get paid on the 21st. So I would rather use Cash App to me because it's like I'm having to wait, and right now I need the donations to continue to help me pay for my room. So I'm asking everybody to donate to your girl. Book a personal reading with me. Get $25 right now. And I do have my motivational candles. I have them here with me. You can look on my community board and they're on there and they're only $5 or $8 now. Okay, so if you want to order one, just inbox me, pinkscorpionintuitive@gmail.com. Don't forget to hit the thumbs up button for me. And share this video. Even if you don't want to watch the video, the whole video, just share it on your page. Share it on your other social media page for me. Okay. Okay, so for my beauty pie. We have somebody who's trying to keep you in a Venus flytrap. They was trying to keep you hanging. But you become awakened to this and you started manifesting your own, you know, ideas, your own happiness and stuff. This person is trying to throw spell work at you to put you in a Venus flytrap. But see, it's not working. You're no longer in that Venus flytrap. Some of you divine feminists, it could be a feminine energy that's like a she-devil that can be trying to keep you in trap. Now, this card shows feminine energies, okay? But it's still the energy of someone that's trying to keep you trapped and either doing some sort of spell work that you've been awakened to. Show me the energy of this spell work, man. Show me the spell work. Mind games. A snake. Mm-hmm. This person targeted you. They want you to be a monkey in their little circus. They want to mind fuck you, play games with you. I see some of you is sitting here and you're dreaming about your transformation. But this person is doing, you know, sex magic on you. They have you in a daze. It's not for everybody. It's a young feminine energy out there. Your man is doing sex magic on you. He wants you naked all the time. He could even gave you some earrings, some bangles, some big gold things. They could have an attachment, some spell work attached to them. So I suggest you take them off, you cleanse them, you sage yourself and take a spiritual bath, because it's some sort of way this person is trying to control you with these bangles. You see them bangles around here? Okay? Yeah. Because you have, you know, you have your third eye, you know how to use your sixth sense. You have extra creative sensor. Okay? You have the power to create. And see, this person, they don't know it, but the demon in them knows. So the demon uses this person or these people to come to you, to try to control you, to try to manipulate you, to try to keep you hanging when they know that you're supposed to be out here either singing, dancing, playing music, creating something, taking pictures, something you're supposed to be doing, creating. So this person is out here throwing spell work at you because they don't want you to be. They just want you to be sitting at home naked all the time. Waiting and hoping for them to come to the door while they're playing mind games with you. Okay, so what is the advice for the divine feminine? The overall advice and the outcome. What is the overall advice and the outcome? What is the advice and the outcome? Don't forget to donate to my channel, Divine Feminine. My Cash App is in the description box below. To my PayPal, I mean, my Cash App and my PayPal is in the description box below. And I'm telling you right now, ahead of time, thank you and I love you because I really need it. And I know you're going to come through for me. I know that. Mm-hmm. Okay, this is the outcome. And I got the advice. This person is going to come to try to give you some jewelry. As an apology, don't you take that necklace. Don't you take them earrings. Don't you take nothing from them. Nothing. If you do, I'ma get my belt and I'ma find you. And I'm becoming auntie. Auntie, gonna whoop your ass if you accept any jewelry from any of these motherfuckers. From this casual relationship, don't, because they want you to stay in that shit. No, you gotta cleanse your energy. Fuck this. No. Don't you take nothing from them. I don't care if it's a key ring. Don't take shit. Don't take no money. I don't care if they offer you a car, don't. If you don't know what I'm talking about, offering a car, just like on the Oval. When Gary gave Andy, if y'all watched the Oval, an old episode, he gave her either some big fancy car, I can't remember. I don't know if it was a Rolls Royce or what. And he bought her $1 million condo and shit. Told her no strings attached, but he was had his own place across the street with a motherfucking telescope watching her having sex. She thinks she free because the windows is open because they up in a high-rise building. He rented a place across the street. So, don't accept this gift because it's just a way for them to put you back in this cage. See, you like this little butterfly right here. You got out. You flew out. And this person be like, they want to put you back in. And this is how you sitting here looking sad and cheated because you don't want to go back in there. You'd rather be free. That other little shit right there, that's just a little place for you just stay. You can't move. You can't evolve. You can't do nothing. This is where they want you, playing mind games with you. You see the chessboard down there? Some of you have a cat, and the cat is looking like, hey, that butterfly is pretty cool like there. Let's get out. Let's go. Okay? Transformation. Okay? So all I have to say is don't let nobody take control of your heart. Don't let nobody put you in some casual ass shit that you don't want to be in. If you told them you don't want that type of energy and they still try to bring it to you, dismiss yourself. Block them and don't call them back because you are too good to be a part of that bullshit. All right? Peace.